is an all-pro kind of show here on the NFL Top 100 Players of 2016 Reactions, presented by TD Ameritrade. Amber Theo Harris with LT. Josh Norman, welcome to the show. Ike Taylor, thanks. Eric Davis. How did it feel to make it in the top 11, the first time you've ever been on the list?
Yeah, I know from not being on it. It's crazy. it's blessings, but it's still more work to do.
You got 11 spots to go.
Yeah, 10 other guys in front of me. Jeez, how could we climb that ladder? So there's still more work to do, man. So, you know, congratulations to them guys. Big ups and respects to them. They deserve it. This is obviously voted by our peers. So I'm feeling very honored and respectful of this.
Well, you have a big year this year. You signed with the Washington Redskins, and team is...
did he?
Dollar.
Guys, stop it, man. We're going to stop. That's it. That's the last time we're going to do it.
Well, the people that are fitting the bill are very proud of you. The Washington Redskins, they say congrats. The Redskins quarterback comes in at number 11 on the NFL Top 100 list. But you played last year. You're with your new team. I'm sure you're excited about that. But you played last year with the Panthers. What made it possible for you to rise this year in the league?
Being myself, staying focused, keeping my head down, and continue to drive. That work, man. Seeing that and maintaining myself and my core values. That's God, family, and football. Everything else was secondary to irrelevant. And stay focused in that and trust in my teammates, and they trust in me to go out and do a job. And that's kind of what you saw.
Let me hear you say it. Yeah. How much of it was the defense and the surrounding group in the huddle with you? How much of it was you as a player?
Well, for me as a player, I think when you put the best 11 on the field, in those best 11, you're going to have guys rise. You have some of them stay the same, or they, like, fall off. For me, I feel like I rose within that defense. And those guys that was on the field, most of them rose too. And you still had the same guys out there making the plays that was making the plays. And I rose. And the same team that I had with me, with the D-line, we can't do it without the D-line. Can't do it without any kind of pressure that's getting on the quarterback.
You
can't.
And we know that.
Exactly. Yeah. So within the secondary, of course, we go hand in hand. You see, you have a good secondary, you're going to have a good front, hopefully you'll say. If you don't have a good front, the secondary got to cover a little while longer. But if you have good coverage, what that front going to do?
Question. Other than your teammates now, who would you ride along with the top 100 at the other opposite cornerback?
Oh, man, that's a good question. I would have to say Joe Hayden, just because I say him, he's a wild card. He got hurt last year. I know a lot of people was probably not putting him up there like that. Because
he was hurt.
Exactly. But I like Joe. He's scrappy. He'll get in there and get that work done. All the other top guys, though, I respect them. Sherm, of course. I mean, that guy can play ball. But Joe, he...
You really like Joe?
I like Joe.
Okay. How about another top guy, Patrick Peterson, making the list at number 18? And this is what he had to say on Twitter. Pinning the number 18 pick to my profile so I remember I have 17 spots to go. Hashtag NFL Top 100. Hashtag Watch Me Work.